Can you hear me?
I see.
Is this thing on?
Oh,
can you hear
hi.
Me?
Hello.
Is this thing on?
All I can see is me face.
Ah, okay? Gadget's working now.
Amazing. Looks like everyone's made it.
Oh, look at all your wee faces.
Wow. Hard to believe it's been 20 years already since 9/11 changed all of our lives.
Feels like 20 hours ago if you ask me.
Well, I tells you, I'm thrilled we're still able to see each other with this good-for-nothing virus chaos and chaos.
I know. Our last reunion 10 years ago in person was brill. But a virtual reunion's better than nothing. Feels like I get to experience the Newfoundlanders' love all over again.
That's right. They certainly know how to welcome people in.
Well, allow us to do it again. On the northeast tip of North America, on an island called Newfoundland, there's an airport.
Now, it used to be one of the biggest airports in the world, and next to it is a town called Gander.
Welcome to the rock if you come from away. Now we understand about a half of what we say. See, no man's an island, but an island makes a man.
Especially when one comes from more like Newfoundland.
Welcome to the rock.
I'm an islander, I am an islander, I'm an islander, I am.
Welcome to the land where the winters tried to kill us and we said
we will not be killed.
Welcome to the land where the waters tried to drown us and we said
we will not be drowned.
Welcome to the land where we lost our loved ones and we said
we will still go on.
Welcome to the land where the wind tried to blow
and we said no.
That morning I dropped my kids off to school and I head for the SPCA where I'm greeted by my other animal kids.
I'm in my cruiser helping the kids cross Airport Boulevard to get to school.
I'm in the classroom on the first day back and the buses are on strike.
I'm sitting 1 second to myself and I'm sitting in my car.
I'm in the library.
And I'm in the staff room.
And I turn on the radio.
You are here at the start of the moment. On the edge of the world, where the river meets the sea. Here, on the edge of the Atlantic, on an island in between, there and here, where our story starts.
My first day at the station.
Where the land and night.
I'm getting coffee for the picket line.
Where we know by heart.
Minutes till my smoke breaks.
Every single flight.
I'm off to work at the airport.
Welcome to the fog. Welcome to the trees. To the ocean and the sky and whatever's in between. To the ones you've left, you're never truly gone. The candles in the window and the kettle's always on.
When the sun is coming up and the world has come ashore. If you're hoping for a harbor, then you'll find it open door. Through the winter, from the water, through whatever's in the way. To the ones who have come from away. Welcome to the rock.
Now that is definitely what you call a welcome.
Well, we try. Although I can't say any of us were prepared for the heaps here that were going to be joining us.
You can say that again. All of us were just in awe seeing those planes fill up our runways.
Well, now you weren't the only one stressing. Even though I'd been a pilot 25 years already, nothing could have prepared me for what we were faced. We're heading into runway 22, and I think, where am I gonna park this thing? There are planes lined up like sardines as far as I can see, and there's cars lined up too. It looks like everybody in Newfoundland is here.
One plane and another, and another.
Is this on? Sorry, I'm new. This is Rogers TV, Channel 9, and I'm Janice Mosher. And I'm reporting live from Gander Airport. The 19th plane has just touched down. I'm here with...
Bonnie Harris. Now, on a normal day, we get a half dozen flights. We got already three times that many landing in 2 hours. It's a lot of noise. You can smell the fuel. You can smell the exhaust.
Jesus, that's a jumbo. There's got to be 250, 300 on her. And that's a fairly large one, there's got to be 200 on her. And now, I'm adding this up, and we've got 38 planes, we've got 300 people on the average.
And then 38, 38, 38, 38, 38, 38.
Holy shit.
And then, all of a sudden, the population of Gander went from 8,000 to 15,000 in just a matter of hours.
But of course we had to do something.
That's right. I just remember the whole town being on its feet, rushing around, panicking, preparing, and just making sure that we could look after our new guests.
11:53 a.m. Tuesday, September 11th, 2001. Any available community buildings will be converted into shelters. With thousands of passengers arriving at any minute, the town is asking for your help with... well, anything you can do.
Crystal, I saw on the news that they're looking for blankets and bedding and maybe some food.
Do you know what they need and how much?
I need something to do because I can't watch the news anymore.
Can I help? Is there something? I need to do something to keep me from thinking of all of those scenes on the tube.
I need something to do because I can't watch the news.
No, I can't watch the news anymore.
What do we need?
I need a tray of sandwiches.
We'll need 50 more.
Sandwiches!
Trays!
What do we need?
200 gym mats. Is that enough?
You tell me and we'll both know.
What do we need?
For the love of God, stop bringing toilet paper to the Lions Club.
How do you know what you need when you don't know how many you're needing to feed when you don't know how many you're saying? How long you're staying, we better start bringing the Wednesdays
nice. In the winter from the water, in the winter from the water,
in the winter from the water,
through the winter from the water,
if a stranger ends up sent by fate.
Are we gonna be ready?
Well, we have to be, don't we?
Well, I know for a fact that I would have preferred to be running around and panicking than be stuck on my plane.
Tell me about it. It was hell on board. Ach, now you guys got to sit and relax. Being on the plane was definitely the easier option here. Excuse me, we were trapped, literally in a prison. When you include the original flight, we were on the plane for 13 hours.
We were on there for 15 hours.
20 hours.
28 hours. We were on the plane for over an entire day.
28 hours, over an entire day. There was one aisle in the middle. Everyone knew every inch of the plane.
We were allowed out of our seats, but not off the plane.
You never think about it, but airplane doors are 20 feet in the air.
And even if you survived the jump, they probably would have shot you.
You can go up to first class. You can stretch in the aisles.
There were three seats on each side and just one aisle in the middle.
Everyone knew every inch of that plane.
Our flight was full. There were children sleeping on the floor.
We had no way to get information.
This was before most people had mobile phones. Only a couple people got through.
Hello?
Mom!
Bonjour?
Operator?
Tom! Oh, thank God, I finally got through. I borrowed a passenger's phone. How are you? Are the kids okay? No, I'm fine, Tom. I'm fine. Safe and sound on the ground here in Newfoundland. We don't know much except for the BBC. Listen, I can talk long. Can you do something for me?
I'm okay.
I'm fine.
Leave, yeah.
Pick up.
Tell the kids I'm alright. Take them into the kitchen and show them the map that we used to put pins in. For each destination that we flew together, tell them I'm fine, put a pin here in Gander.
Although I do recall a certain gentleman coming up to my room asking to join me.
You do?
Yes, indeed I do. Now what was it he asked me?
Excuse me, do you mind if I sit here? I need to get some work done and there are some people shouting at the top of their lungs.
No, of course, I'm Diane.
Nick, how are you?
I'm worried about someone. He was flying today. I just wish there was some way to tell him where I am.
Newfoundland? Oh, you already know that. You just can't tell them. I hope you're one of those people who laughs when English people say stupid things.
You got through to the airline? Tom, I'm okay. Tell me what's happening out there. How bad is it? Tell me everything. Tom, who was in the air? No, I wouldn't have known them. No, no one on that airline. Charles? Are you sure? No, I'm fine, Tom. I'm fine.
Eventually, those 28 hours were finally over, and we were able to leave the airplane.
I just remember being greeted by a large amount of buses, with an intimidating amount of smiling people stood beside them.
Well, we thought it'd be a great idea to dust off our Salvation Army uniforms and wear them to show these newcomers that we meant to help.
There are soldiers waiting for us!
Well, once we got our new guests on the buses, either willingly or out of sheer fear, I guess, we whisked them into town to get them settled, or at least more comfortable.
Welcome to Gander Academy. I'm going to show you now to your rooms, and then if you want to come back, we got two TVs set up in the cafeteria with the news on, so you can actually see what's happened for yourselves.
I didn't even think. I haven't seen any of it yet.
Lead us out of the darkness.
They're all staring at those images and we just stand helpless watching them.
Lead us home to safety.
We barely know where we are, but we know it's not there.
Lead us far from disaster.
Charles Burlingham was the captain of Flight 77 that crashed into the Pentagon. I just saw him at a pub in London. You can't imagine. A pilot will fight to the ends of the earth to save his airplane. He just will.
Lead us out of the night.
We watch those images for hours. Until someone finally turns it off.
We were shown to our beds. Literally, they had a mattress of some kind for each and every one of us.
Well, we can't have any guests that stay with us have a poor night's sleep.
We were also somehow each given clothes that had been donated by the locals.
Well, we can't have any guests that stay with us have nothing clean to wear.
And at 4 a.m, I was woken to the smell of freshly baked bread and other foods.
Well, we can't have any guests that stay with us get hungry. 4 a.m. is breakfast time in Germany, so we start scrambling eggs.
I mean, hospitable doesn't even come close.
Oh, that's when Nick bumped into me again.
Diane, oh, I'm glad I found you. Have you done something with your hair? I like it.
Well, thank you. No shampoo for 4 days.
I was ready to leave the minute I set foot on Gander. Yes, everyone was so nice and friendly, but I was wearing a stranger's clothes, stuck hundreds of miles from home, and I still had no idea when I would get to see my family.
I was told about a woman trying to contact her son. I'm a mother too, and I couldn't bear to think what she was going through. So I went to find her just to see if I could help. Excuse me, are you Hannah?
Yeah, that's me.
My name's Beulah. Someone told me your son's a firefighter. Yeah, mine is too, here in town. And I know Gander's not New York, but is there anything I can do?
No, I just need to hear from my son.
I understand.
Praying for a phone call.
Praying for a way home. Asking questions. Asking can I get back on that godforsaken plane.
And all around me people chat.
And people snap like nothing's happened. And I need to hear we're going back before I go insane.
I'm phoning literally anyone I know from any airline. I just need to know when I'll be able to get reunited with the sky again and get these scared people back home.
I remember going on walks with Diane into the local area and gradually filling up my camera full of pictures of the wildlife, the food and her.
He even took me to a bar one night.
She was getting fairly flirtatious with me that night.
Now, I had never had more than one beer in one sitting before, so when I finished my second, it was probably the alcohol talking.
So I bought us two more beers.
Anyway, I was getting lunch set up, labeling anything that'll go bad with the date and time. I let the pants off one of the pilots who had been enjoying our cooking, made a balloon animal for a crying toddler, and then I checked on Hannah, leaving messages for anyone she can reach.
I am here, I am here. Hello? Hello, it's me again. Yep, my son, he's with rescue too. Any news? I am his mother. I'm far away, stuck here. I'm trying to find out if... Fine, hold again. I should be down there and checking the hospitals, putting up signs, doing something. Instead, I am here. I am here in Canada. I'm telling you, listen, my son, he takes risks, he's not missing, he's helping or hurt, he'll get out of this. Yes, I'll keep trying, and yes, here's the number, and yes, at the Legion in Gander, I'll be right here. I should be there when it's over and done, when he comes through the door and says, I'm home, Mom. I should be there for my son, but instead I am here, I am here.
She leaves message after message for her son, until there's no more room on his answering machine.
All I know is you are there. You are there. And I am here.
And then I get the news we were all waiting to hear. Finally, after 5 days, we were able to get back up in the air and get everyone back home.
It's strange, though. Some of us felt like we almost didn't want to leave quite yet.
These people had shown us nothing but the greatest kindness I'd ever experienced. And now it was just suddenly ending. We didn't even have time to play gifts or signs of gratitude.
And so we all boarded our flights and said goodbye to the place that we'd very briefly called home. but it felt like a part of us stayed in Gander even after our planes took off.
The winds start to pick up. 50-mile-an-hour winds. We've been here too long. We're only just off the ground. There's a hurricane coming, and I'm thinking we're running out of time. But soon those clouds part and I see something all too familiar. Ladies and gentlemen, if you look out your windows, you won't want to miss this. We've just entered Texas.
Somewhere in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of who knows where you'll find time. In the middle of something, in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of clear blue air, you found your heart but left a part of you behind.
Everyone's drinking and compare stories.
What'd you say? What'd you do?
But mostly, Nick and I spent the plane ride home canoodling in the back.
At one point, a flight attendant comes around saying,
hot towel, hot towel, cold towel.
Somewhere in between the place of life and work and where you're going, something makes you stop and notice, and you're finally in the moment. Somewhere in the middle of nowhere, in the middle of who knows where, knows where you'll find.
As we touched down and taxied in, we're all cheering, we're down, we're home. I'm thanking everyone, hugging my crew. I run past the gate, up the stairs, and I'm there. And he's waiting in line. No, I'm fine, Tom. I'm fine.
So you'll call?
As soon as I get back.
And then he left.
And then I was alone.
At the end of the day, after everyone left,
we all tried to go back to normal, except...
the town was more quiet and somehow far emptier.
We all look the same, but we're different than we were.
The Board of Health says clean it up, every part.
So we start.
I get home and start to unpack my suitcase. I'm so glad to be back in England, but then I pick up my camera and I start to cry.
My dad hugs me as soon as I get home. He asks if I'm okay, but how do I tell him I'm not? I'm so much better than okay. Am I allowed to be happy about being there?
I phone American Airlines and say I'm ready to go wherever you want to send me, but they say take a few days off. I phone every day and I'm back in the airport on Thursday and it's empty, silent. It's just a different place, and I stop what few passengers there are and I say thank you for still flying.
I get a call I hoped I wouldn't receive. Hello, you've reached Gander Academy. This is Beulah Davis. How can I help you?
He's gone. It's over.
Oh no. I'm sorry, Hannah. I'm so sorry.
You are here. The end of a moment. The end of the world. You are here. On the edge of the ocean where the story ends.
At the office.
In an airport.
In my house.
On an island.
At the station,
in my car,
and wherever you are, you are here.
Well, I guess that's pretty much it, isn't it?
And what's that supposed to mean?
Well, we all made it home and you guys went back to normal too, yeah?
You know fine rightly that no one was ever the same after that.
We lost something.
We found something.
And we were strong enough to move on.
Exactly. Nobody's story was over once they got home. They weren't over 10 years ago, and even now, 20 years on, they still aren't over.
Damn right. Those events impacted so much of my future. Why, with all the new security, kids aren't even allowed into the cockpit anymore. Of course, on my retirement flight, I brought my whole family into the cockpit on our way back to Gander.
Nick and I just... couldn't make the long-distance relationship work.
So I moved to Texas, and then I proposed.
And we honeymooned in Newfoundland!
Beulah and I still keep in touch. She even came to visit me in New York. And I'll still phone her if I hear a really stupid joke.
The donation we are most honoured by arrived in 2011.
It's about 4 metres long and 1,200 kilograms.
Newfoundland is the only place outside the United States that shares the steel from the World Trade Center.
On the northeast tip of North America, on an island called Newfoundland, there's an airport, and next to it, there's a town called Gander.
Tonight we honour what we lost.
But we also celebrated what we found.
You are here at the start of a moment on the edge of the world.
Welcome to the fog, welcome to the trees, a kiss and a cod and whatever's in between. To the ones who left, you're never truly gone. A candle's in the window and the cattle's always on.
To the coves and the caves and the people on the plains.
In 5 days,
19 animals
and 7,000 strays.
If you're looking for a hunger, then you'll find an open door. In the winter from the light of the night.